from the underground. They're using a swift build of your techniques. Underground, Shanghai Brothers, win, lose, or draw. Put your money on the floor, kid, and bring $7,000. Check it. Ill White hat still. He could have been there with the real Cinnamon Mill, but instead, he chose the high price. Here comes another sellout who got what he wants to get paid regardless of respect. We live hip-hop, straight up in our stop. And when it first began, we present $7,000. Ill Mike came in 12 deep. But when it was on, all you heard was rugged, real tight, great beat.
What's up, man? What's going on? First of all, I'd like to say peace. What's up, everybody? How y'all feel? You know what I'm saying? I'm up here in the Bronx with Mr. Wiggles. We in his little lab called the One Tunnel. This is where we derive and come up with ideas and try to produce music and lyrics for our shows that we do for Rock Steady Crew and also for Get Original Productions. Basically, what I'm going to do with y'all is just, you know, share with y'all a little bit of my experiences in b-boying, and I'm going to continue my crusade of trying to, you know, give what I have and my knowledge of 17, 18 years of b-boying to the rest of y'all with some of my footage from when I go traveling around and stuff like that. But then again, be on the lookout because I'm going to put together a tape that deals with a lot of my first break-in from 1979 up to 1997, which should be coming out real soon. So this is it, y'all. Peace and love.
Yo, check this out.
Yo,
we got some little niggas to wiggle. Pay my motherfucking dudes. Ain't got nobody
going in 70s, 80s, 90s. I'm about to rob your mother right now. What about you? I need my pop.
Want some freeze in the house?
Right here is go back, way back, back into time.
I'd like to make it right. Thank you.
up to Mr. Freeze.
Everyone's got to make a living.
Ken Swift.
Children grow and women produce and men go work in some to steal. Everyone's got to make a living. Children grow and women produce and men go work in some to steal. Everyone's got to make a living.
Thank you.
Yeah!
little bit of history about, you know, my, my start in B-boying and how it all started, blah, blah, blah. I moved to a new neighborhood, 97th Street and Amsterdam Avenue, in 1979, beginning of 79, and hooked up with Doles, ran into Doles. He was living in the same building as me. He lived on the third floor, I lived on the second floor, and, you know, a few other buddies that I have from 96 in Amsterdam, Andy, which is Baby Love's brother, we have Puerto Rican Chick, Dino Rock, and White Chick, and a lot of other brothers that was down with YCB, which is Young City Boys. That's the crew I started when I hooked up with Doles. You know, writing graph and stuff like that. We started doing DJing. We started DJing and MCing. And, you know, we started eventually bringing our equipment out. Doles had went up to the Bronx and with his cousin Slimmy D, and they was going to jams, and Doles came back down and he was like, yo, you know, these kids are doing this breaking stuff, this b-boying stuff in the Bronx. And he showed me a little shuffle, and I was like, yo, that's fat, you know what I'm saying? I want to try it. I tried it, and, you know, I did a few moves, and he thought I was doing it already, but I had just tried it from seeing him. And basically, that's the jump that I got on it. I started, you know, getting more interested in finding out more about it. So, you know, started bugging out with simple foundation shuffles and regular footwork and small freezes, because that's basically what was happening back then. Small baby freezes, it wasn't that much. That's the first stuff I saw. My boy Dante, he also was an influence because he had been living in the east side of 1st Avenue, 91st Street, and he had been going around his neighborhood and seeing kids doing it also. You know, so I seen him one day, I was walking with him in front of a record shop. He did a spin, top spin, and a split. And he got up, and I was like, this before I started, I was like, yo, man. In my mind, I was like, what's wrong with you, man? You're just jumping on the floor, people looking at you, you know what I'm saying? I was kind of like embarrassed a little bit, but the thing that intrigued me was the way that he didn't care what people thought. He just did what he felt when the beats was on. When the music played, he just reacted, and that was fat. So it was another inspiration of mine. I started the YCB crew, Young City Boys crew, and we started doing it, going to battles, and we started battling. As I was doing that, I met Frosty Freeze, and Frosty Freeze's cousin, Todd Fly, was down with Young City Boys, and Frosty Freeze was like the most popular breaker that I knew my neighborhood. He was real popular. He was good. He had the real flavor, which was a lot of character. You know, his character stood out more than his actual dance, because he just had a good attitude when he danced. So Frosty was funny, and he was a crowd pleaser. Everybody liked him. He was like down with us in a sense. He never wore rock, Young City wore colors, but he was down with us because, you know, we was all, I had a little squad, and he liked the, you know, the energy we had. He ran into Legs, you know what I'm saying? He told Legs about me, boom, and then I battled Legs, and that's how I got down Rock Steady. From that point on, I mean, I was inspired by some of the people that I saw were coming down from the Bronx, like Spy, Track, Little Lep was an inspiration, you know, Easy Mike, definitely Spider-Man, JoJo, Jimmy D, you know, these brothers, Jimmy Lee, these brothers came down, and I learned a lot about, you know, flavor, you know what I'm saying, how it gotta be. I looked at them and I said, these brothers are characters. And, you know, so in the beginning, I was fortunate to be around some top pioneers like they were, because they were pioneers of the underground, real raw breaking, you know, before it even came exposed to cameras in Hollywood. So, you know, I was like in a sense too part of that, but a couple years after I started, we started getting involved with, you know, the whole commercialism and the whole exploitation and exposure of b-boying as part of hip-hop, because hip-hop is also booming in itself. So, you know, that's basically what happened. My style and my technique is exactly what it is. It's my style. A lot of times when I first started, I saw brothers like Grego from The Executioners. He's from the east side. And I saw him break in an outdoor street, park jam. And I was amazed at what I saw, and I wanted to be like and look like exactly like what he did. I was like, that's the way I need to look. And as much as I tried to look like him, I couldn't, because I'm myself. I mean, I tried, but I just looked at myself and felt like, I can't even do it like him. So basically, I had no choice but to depend on my own stuff. You can see right here, this train, you know what I'm saying, bombs. Commercial. Coming soon to a theater near you. Wild style too.
depend on my own style, my own flavor. And what helped me out was I started practicing by myself early in the mornings in Rocksteady Park by myself. And I just had to depend on whatever I made up. If I made up a new freeze or a new move, I didn't have no one there to ask about, yo, this is cool, you know, this looks good. And they say, yeah, it's dope, boy, that shit's whack. I have nobody to depend on. So I would do everything and just be confident with it and depend on my emotions and how I felt and just, you know, my movement. From that point on, I mean, you know, when it comes to making up moves, I depend on the foundation of breaking. I depend on all the original first things that started in breaking. First moves, sweeps, chairs, figure fours, corkscrews, swipes, bridges, tracks. When you know the foundation of breaking, these are like the main elements for you to build your vocabulary in breaking. You learn all the big moves, all the air moves. There's a lot of things that ways that people call them. Big moves, air moves, power moves. You call it what you want it, but the foundations will open up the doors to all of those big moves. Combinations I like, the quick freeze style is what I like. It's like quick freezes with all of this stuff. Grego was one of the first inspirations I saw doing like a quick freeze style, because freezes were so popular. Seeing him do them, I was inspired. I seen another brother from Manhattan Projects named Shaky. He was a Boricua. He was going at it. He had learned from Brownie, from the Bronx. You know, rubber band in them. And Kid Terrific was down with the number one short shot boys, and hell out my older brother Speedy. My older brother was rocking with the number one short shot boys and the other crews around Manhattan, lower downtown from where I was at with the Midnight Rockers and La Familia. And from La Familia, some of the brothers, Amigo and Migo Rock, they got down rock steady, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, these are the people that inspired me. And to this day, I have the utmost respect for them. And every chance I get, I try to get
it. Rocksteady, who comes? Rocksteady, Robin. Peace.
down there. Wanna get that off?
out to my man, Mr. Wiggles, real quick.